الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. فقد قال الله تعالى في محكم التنزيل والفرقان المجيد وهو أصدق القائلين: من ذا الذي يقرض الله قرضا حسنا يضاعف له أجرا يضاعف له أضعافا كثيرة. وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام: اغتنم خمسا قبل خمس، شبابك قبل هرمك، وحياتك قبل موتك، وغناك قبل فقرك، وصحتك قبل سقمك، وحياتك قبل موتك، وفراغك قبل شغلك، أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام، رواه حاكم. صدق الله العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم، ونحن على ذلك لمن الشاهدين والشاكرين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. We give praise and thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we send darood and salam on our Prophet Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his household, his companions, and all believing men and women who follow them until the end of time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has alhamdulillah blessed us and has made us from those fortunate ones that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted us life, spare our life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has gathered us to hear some reminders. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَذَكِّرْ فَإِنَّ الذِّكْرَ تَنْفَعُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. So remind, for verily reminders are benefit for the believers. And today, our reminder, inshallah, will not be too long, but also will be not to be too short, but to be in such a point which inshallah we'll be able to take some benefit and we'll be able to learn some lesson. And our reminder today is about the hadith Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, narrated by Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, he said, take benefit of five things before five. Utilize five things which we are all blessed with as mankind, we are all blessed with as humans. Utilize these things before five things were to overpower you and to overcome you. And from among this, the first one Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, shababaka qabla haramik, your youth before old age, your prime time, when you're physically more capable of doing things than at such a time when you become weak physically. We know as youth, as someone who is young, they have more strength, they have much more enthusiasm and drive in doing actions. And if we were to utilize these aspects, these qualities, this sifat that is among youth, utilize it in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in drawing nearness towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in doing ibadat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raises the levels of such individual. In fact, such a person who devote his youth, who devote his prime time, his prime health, his strength, and enthusiasm in worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promises such reward for such a person which we cannot comprehend. And for this reward, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned a hadith regarding the day of judgment, when we know of the terrifying day of the day of judgment, the day of resurrection. It will not be such an easy day as our day-to-day life. We know in summertime when the temperature reaches in the 90, we cry out of heat. The day of judgment will be so terrifying with heat As Rasulullah mentioned the hadith, that people will be drunk in their own sweat. There will be different levels that people will be standing in the sweat, from the ankles up to the time when they will be drunk in their sweat. And on that day there will be no shade except the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And from among this category, Rasulullah mentioned there's seven people, سَبْعَةٌ يَذِلُّهُمُ اللَّهُ يَوْمَ لَا ذِلَّ إِلَّا ذِلُّهُ. That seven people whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will place under his shade. On that day, the day of judgment, will there be no other shade. And from among this seven category is a category Rasulullah made mention, شَابٌ نَشَأَ فِي عِبَادَةِ اللَّهِ. Is a youth, a youngster, who spend his life, who grows up in the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He devote his prime time, he devote that time when he has those strong urges and enthusiasm, he devote it all in the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we see in utilizing, taking benefit of our youth, the important it is, the important reward it gives is something that we cannot comprehend. And from the advice of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that is one thing he advises us, remind us to take benefit of before we were to lose that time of youth. Because when that time of youth pass, we will not have that opportunity again. The time of youth is a time when we have much more free times, as we say, time without responsibilities. You don't have anyone that you have to take care of, and that responsibility is not laid up on your shoulder, except in the rare occasions. But yes, you still have that more physical strength, you still have that more enthusiasm. And that's the prime time when also shaitan plays with the individual to take them astray, to indulge in illicit affairs, to indulge in sins. But that youth, when he utilizes all of those aspects and he turns it against sins, but he turns towards obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, towards goodness, he will be rewarded drastically. And from the second advice Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, is sihhatika qabla saqamik. Take benefit, make use of your health before sickness. No one of us can guarantee how we will be tomorrow. In fact, now is Salatul Jum'ah, the time of Zuhr Salah, midday, just after midday. None of us know what will happen to us before Salatul Asr. We are healthy now, no one knows what state and what condition will be at the time for Asr Salah. We cannot guarantee ourselves with our own health. We know the pandemic that is befalling us across the world. So many of our loved ones have lost their life, have been taken away from us. None of us predicted this. No one could have guaranteed that our loved ones, our beloved ones that passed away, will be alive today. So our health, our good health, when we have it, we have to take benefit from it and utilize it in the best way. And what better way than to utilize our health in the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned a hadith narrated by Abbas radiallahu anhu. نِعْمَتَانِ مَقْبُونٌ فِيهِمَا كَثِيرٌ مِّنَ النَّاسِ. That there are two favors which mankind have been blessed with, but instead of utilizing, mankind have lost their way in it. They are lost in these two favors. They don't take benefit of these two favors. In fact, they have misused these two favors. And from those two favors, one of them, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, as-siha, is that of your health. We have our health, but instead of us utilizing our health in good pursuits, in good actions, which will benefit us not only in this world but in the hereafter, we are utilizing our health in the wrong pursuits, in the wrong affairs, towards sins. So let us realize that this health that we have, it is not guaranteed until when we'll be healthy. This blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is something that we take for granted. But let us not just take it for granted, but let us utilize it in the best way. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned that whosoever begins his day when he is secure with his property, his wealth is secure, he is in good health, he starts his day, he wakes up in the morning and he is in good health, and he has possessions for throughout his day, that He know he'll have his meal for lunch. He know he'll have his meal for dinner, for supper. Then, there's such a person who have waken up that morning and he have these three aspects. It's as if he's possessed the whole world. It is as if he has wealth of the whole world. So, Alhamdulillah, many of us in the morning we get up. These three aspects we fulfill. We have nothing to worry about. We know that Alhamdulillah we'll be blessed to have another meal on our table. We know Alhamdulillah we wake up, our family is safe, our wealth is safe. Or Alhamdulillah we wake up in such good health that many of us even at the time sad to say we wake up in that morning, but we wake up without and forgetting about praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We cite in the dua, Alhamdulillah alladhi ahyana ba'dama amatana wa ilayhi nushur. We forget to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for granting us another breath in the morning that we wake. So let us utilize our health in worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Take benefit of our health in following the footsteps of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his companions. The third Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reminds us to take benefit of is that ghinaka qabla faqrik, our wealth before poverty. The wealth that we have is an amanat, is a trust from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It does not belong to us, but in fact Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala entrusted it towards us in seeing how will we recompense and how will we make benefit of this trust that we've been given with. Are we going to fulfill the trust in ways such as charity? Are we going to see someone suffer and do not spend from our pocket, from our wealth to benefit that person? Are we going to utilize our wealth that it may be a means for our salvation and day of judgment? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in a hadith that on the day of judgment, no person will be able to move. The son of Adam will not be able to take a step forward until he is asked and he answers this question. In that, there's five questions he'll be asked, and from among those questions is one, how did he acquire his wealth and where did he spend it? So wealth that we have, it doesn't have to be you're a millionaire or billionaire. That sin that you have, even if it is out of necessity, how do we acquire it? Did we acquire it in halal means? Did we gain that money in halal way, in halal method? And how do we spend it? Do we spend it in ways to benefit us in this life and the hereafter? So our wealth, my respected gathering, it is a trust by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to us. Let us utilize it. Let us invest our wealth in the hereafter, helping the needy, providing for the orphans, helping the widows, and other aspects of charity that is there that we can utilize as a form of sadaqah, as a form of charity that will achieve us and will gain us towards the hereafter, success in the hereafter. The fourth one Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned is that faragaka qabla shughulik, your free time before your preoccupation, before you're occupied. And go back towards the hadith I mentioned of the two favors that mankind are lost in, that mankind do not take benefit in, that mankind misuse. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, and from one of them I said was that of health. The second favor Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned there was that of our free time. As-sihhatu wal-farag, your health and your free time. So free time, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam admonishes and he reminds us, is a favor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but mankind, we misuse this favor. We don't utilize it, we don't take benefit from it, and we don't make use of it in the best way possible. We know many of us today, especially with the situation we've been in lockdown, we've had so many times at our hand that today many people are saying they're bored. And you ask, the reason they're bored is because they've been home. They're home, they have nothing to do. That tells you of the amount of free time that is there. But how do we utilize free time? Are we utilizing it in ways that can gain us closer towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? In ways that will benefit us to achieve higher ranks in Jannah? In ways that will gain us close towards the companionship of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the day of judgment? So our free time, and wasting our free time in idle things, is something which is not recommended, or is not recommended and advisable in Islam. We should always try to utilize our free time in remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. in some acts of dhikr, in some acts of tilawat, reciting the Quran, some acts of worship, even just saying subhanallah, glory be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, alhamdulillah, all praise for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allahu Akbar, Allah is the greatest. Even these simple form of dhikr, the reward is tremendous that we cannot comprehend. So our free time should not actually be free time. Instead, it should be time that we utilize in achieving and gaining closeness towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And last, from the advice of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to take benefit of, is that of hayataka qabla mawtik. We all sitting here, we all present here, we all listening to this advice is because of one ni'mah, one blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is that of our life. Whether we are sick, whether we are in our bed, whether we are bedridden, we cannot move, but the fact that we can listen to this, the mere fact that we are present here in this world is a ni'mah, is a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from among His favors. And that blessing is that of life. In whatever state we may be, we cannot deny that the fact that we have life is a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam last advice, which I will close with, is that take benefit of your life, make use of your life before death come upon you. We all know death is a certainty. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ. Worship your Rabb, worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until certainty comes upon you. And the scholars and the mufassireen have agreed that certainty here, the word which was used in this verse, was not a word referred to maut, death, but it was used certainty. And scholars agree that this certainty is referring to death only. Because that is the most certain things which everyone has to face and no one can deny. Kullu nafsin dha'iqat al-maut. Everyone, every soul shall have a taste of death. No one can deny this fact. No matter how great of a scientist he is, no matter how great of a world power and how wealthy he is in the world, cannot deny the fact of death has to come upon us. So we know the certainty of death coming to us. So our life, we know it is not guaranteed. We know one thing which is guaranteed for sure is death. So our life we should utilize towards our certainty that we have to face. The certainty of death, how do we utilize our life to prepare and be ready for that certainty to befall on us? Let us utilize and take advantage of our life before death come upon us. Let us take benefit and let us strive in our best way that our life should be one which, when death come upon us, when Malakul Maud, the angel of death, is before us, we are willing and we are ready that we can say, oh alhamdulillah, I'm ready to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alhamdulillah, I'm ready to leave this dunya. I'm ready to leave this world. Or you feel content that you have done such actions in your life, or you have utilized your life solely for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that you know we have to return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you're ready to go back toward your Creator. You're ready to face your Creator, you're ready to return towards your Creator, because your life have utilized for that purpose. So let us try and remember, let us reflect upon these five things Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us to take benefit of. Because all these five things, there is a counterpart, there is an opposite for it. That it is not for granted, all of it we have, and at some point it can all go from us. Our youth, we will not remain young forever, we will not be in a stage of teenager or in a state of youthfulness throughout our life. Our health, no matter what time of our life or what year in our life it is, our health is not something that can be guaranteed. We can be healthy today and tomorrow, we can be sick, we can be crippled for the rest of our life. Our wealth, again, it is not something that is meant to last forever. Many a person happen in reality of our life, they wake up or they go to sleep in the night wealthy, and in the morning they wake up, they are poor, they are in poverty. Or they wake up in the morning wealthy, and in the night before they go to sleep, they are in poverty. So wealth, as much as we have it, at that time when we have it, let us not hold it back, and let us not delay in utilizing it for the benefit of Allah, for the benefit of our life, in gaining closeness towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our free time, again, it's not always going to be there waiting for us. We know when this lockdown has officially been lifted, when everyone will go back to their normal routine, then we will cry and we'll say, how I wish we were to return back towards that time we had our free time. How I wish I was to return back when I was home all day with my family. Our free time, let us utilize it for the best purpose, for our own upliftment, for achieving Jannah, for achieving our greatness in the hereafter. And last but not least, our life. Let us take benefit of our life, which we all know we have to leave one day. We all have to leave this world one day. We all will lose our life. That this life is not forever. It is not that we remain here forever. So I pray and beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He grant us understanding. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us that we can utilize all of these five aspects and all of the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Utilize it in the best of ability, in the best of way. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us that when we die in a state of iman and we die submissive to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول ما تسمعون واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، فقد قال الله تعالى في محكم التنزيل والفرقان المجيد: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام في الحديث: من صلى علي واحدة صلى الله بعشرة. اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وسيدنا مولانا محمد وبارك وسلم. وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام: أرحم أمتي بأمتي أبو بكر، وأشدهم في أمر الله عمر، وأصدقهم حياء عثمان، وأقضاهم علي، وفاطمة سيدة النساء أهل الجنة، والحسن والحسين سيدا شباب أهل الجنة، وحمسة أسد الله وأسد رسوله. اللهم اغفر العباس وولده مغفرة ظاهرة وباطنة لا تغادر ذنبا، رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين، وعن كل صحابة الباقين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. اللهم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين واخذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداءك أعداء الدين. اللهم انصر المسلمين المستضعفين في كل مكان. اللهم انصر المجاهدين في كل مكان. اللهم أخرج اليهود والنصارى من قلوب المسلمين وأخرج الأقصى من يد الكافرين. اللهم ارحمنا ولا تعذبنا واغفرنا ولا تعذبنا بعذابك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم ارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين. اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين. اللهم رب ارحمهما كما ربيانا صغارا. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. آمين رضوان آمين يا آمين يا رب العالمين. عباد الله، فاعلموا أن الله تعالى أمركم بالثلاث وينهاكم عن الثلاث. فقال تعالى في محكم الكتاب: إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم وادعوه على نعمه يزركم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. قوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله.